Hello students, welcome to EPG Paathshala. I am Dr. Pratibhanan, principal from SP College of Pharmacy, Sonipat. Today we are going to discuss about the module Advances in Ocular Drug Delivery System 2 under the paper Novel Drug Delivery System Part 1. Coming to the objectives, I'll be discussing about the introduction, drug delivery to the anterior segment of the eye with suitable examples and formulations available, drug delivery to the posterior segment of eye with examples and all the formulations available. Regarding the introduction, transport of the drugs applied by traditional dosage form is restricted to the eye and therapeutic drug concentration in the target tissues are not maintained for a longer duration since the eyes are protected by a unique anatomy and physiology. For the treatment of anterior segment of eye, various droppable products to prolong the retention time on the ocular surface have been introduced in the market. On the other hand, direct intravitreal implants using biodegradable or non-biodegradable polymer technology have been widely investigated for the treatment of chronic vitreoretinal diseases. There is an urgent need to develop an ocular drug delivery system which provides controlled release for the treatment of chronic diseases and increase the patient's and doctor's convenience to reduce the dosing frequency and invasive treatment. Drug delivery system to the anterior segment of eye. First one is through eye drops. To prolong the retention time of topically applied drugs in the anterior segment of eye, eye drops utilize interaction between the drug carrier, that means the excipients, and physiological environment of cornea or subconjunctiva. Durasite DDS is based on a polycarbophil aqueous solution. Basically, polycarbophil is polyacrylic acid cross-linked with divinyl glycol and forms hydrogen bonding with the mucus and corneal and conjunctival epitheliums, which are all negatively charged to extend the effects of drugs to several hours. Azurite containing a broad spectrum antibiotics, that is azithromycin ophthalmic solution, was formulated Durasite. It is meant for the treatment of bacterial conjunctivitis and was launched in United States in 2007. This utilizes Durasite, a combination of azithromycin and dexamethasone for the treatment of blepharoconjunctivitis and is currently in phase 3. Bromfenac in Durasite is in phase 1/2 to reduce the inflammation and pain after ocular surgery. Methyl cellulose has a lower critical solution temperature at approximately 50 degrees centigrade, and salt to gel phase transition occurs. Since the temperature of ocular surface is 32 to 34 degrees centigrade, therefore, the lower critical solution temperature, that is LCST, needs to be lower to gel the methyl cellulose solution at ocular surface quickly after instillation as eye drops. In general, high concentration of electrolytes lead to salting out of and gelation of methyl cellulose. Wakamoto Pharmaceutical Co. Limited Company of Japan has developed temperature-responsive eye drops and formulated timolol malate for glaucoma therapy. It is available in Japan using combinations of methyl cellulose, sodium citrate and polyethylene glycol, which can act by lowering the lower critical solution temperature of methyl cellulose. Another example is amberlite. It is a strong cation exchange resin, which is polystyrene sulfonic acid resin cross-linked with diphenyl benzene. Beto Bitopic S has marketed from 1990, where the active ingredients are bitaxolol, and was used for glaucoma therapy and consisted of this resin. Positively charged bitaxolol is bound to the negatively charged sulfonic acid group in the resin. When bitaxolol bound resin is applied to the eye, the cationic ion such as the sodium or the potassium in the tear fluid induce the release of bitaxolol molecules from resin matrix into the tear film and lead to bitaxolol penetration across the cornea. Another example is Tobradex ST, which is a combination of tobramycin 0.3% and dexamethasone 0.05% and has been launched as an anti-inflammatory and anti-infective formulation for blepharitis. It improves the suspension formulation characteristics and quality, tear film kinetics and tissue penetration using xanthan gum and anionic polysaccharide with repeating unit of 2-D-glucose, 2-D-mannose and 1-glucuronic acid residue. The xanthan gum forms anionic interaction with tobramycin to decrease the viscosity of the suspension when compared with that normally expected from xanthan gum. The xanthan gum tobramycin interaction reduces sedimentation of dexamethasone particles and improves suspension characteristics. The viscosity increases after mixing with tears as the interactions between xanthan gum and tobramycin are interrupted by pH and ionic content of the tears. The enhanced viscosity leads longer retention and improves the ocular bioavailability of drugs. Another example is the NovaZorb. NovaZorb is again a cationic emulsion-based preparation which is based on electrostatic attraction that occurs between the oily droplets of a positively charged emulsion loaded with active ingredient and negatively charged ocular surface. Therefore, NovaZorb improves solubility and absorption of lipophilic drugs and also reduces the number of instillation times and side effects, leading to better efficacy and patient compliance. Cation Norms, which is composed of only cationic emulsion without any active ingredient, has been launched for the mild dry eye. Nova 22007 is a cationic emulsion incorporated cyclosporine and has completed phase 3 clinical studies for dry eye syndrome and phase 2/3 studies for vernal keratoconjunctivitis. Contact lens. Soft contact lens based drug delivery system have been investigated by several approaches. First one is soak and absorption of the drug solution. Second one is piggyback contact lens combined with the drug plate or drug solution. And third one is drug modification to immobilize the drugs on the surface of contact lenses. Fourth one, incorporation of the drugs in a colloidal structure dispersed in the lens. Another one, ion ligand containing polymeric hydrogel. And lastly, the molecularly imprinting of the drugs. The soft contact lens based drug delivery devices are being developed by following two companies, but the details have not yet been disclosed. It's Vistakon Pharmaceuticals has completed a multi-center phase 3 clinical trials for a contact lens pre-soaked to release an antihistaminic drug that is ketotifen, to prevent the allergic conjunctivitis in contact lens wearers. Seed Co. Limited and Sanju Pharmaceuticals Co. Limited have co-developed a disposable soft contact lens to release incorporated sodium chromoglycate for one day. They have announced clinical trials for allergic conjunctivitis in Japan and was conducted in 2010. Cul-de-sac inserts its Lacrizette. Lacrizette is basically a rod-shaped water-soluble cul-de-sac insert and composed of hydroxypropyl cellulose without preservatives and other ingredients. Having a diameter of 1.27 mm with a length of 3.5 mm, it is indicated in moderate to severe dry eye syndrome. Lacrizette has not been applied as a drug delivery carrier as yet, although previously many inserts including Collagen Shield, Ocufit SR, a new ophthalmic delivery system, and Minidisc ocular therapeutic system have been developed, but there are no further activities at present. The commercial failure of these inserts might be attributed to the psychological factors, including the reluctance to abandon the traditional droppable formulations, and occasional ejection from the eye was observed in the case of Ocuzert. Ocuzert provides uniform control release of pilocarpine as an ocular hypotensive drug and has been commercialized in 1974. Ocuzert consists of two outer layers of ethylene vinyl acetate copolymer and an inner layer of pilocarpine in alginate gel within diethyl hexyl phthalate for a release enhancer, and sandwiched between ethylene vinyl acetate layers. However, Ocuzert has not become widely used because of unsatisfactory intraocular pressure control due to various causes, including the difficulty of inserting the device, ejection of the device from the eye, and irritation during insertion. Now coming to the punctal plugs. To prolong the retention time and increase the absorption and efficacy after instillation of eye drops, inhibition of drainage through nasolacrimal system using punctal plugs into the puncta is a long-standing approach. Efficacy of an ocular hypotensive agent in eye drops in conjunction with punctal occlusion by punctal plug has been evaluated. Although punctal occlusion significantly decreased approximately 2 mm of mercury intraocular pressure in the plugged eyes, but it was not concluded that this intraocular pressure decrease is clinically significant. Now coming to the subconjunctival or episcleral implants. Lux Biosciences in New Jersey, they developed LX201, a silicon matrix episcleral implant which was designed to deliver cyclosporin A to the ocular surface for 1 year. This implant is flat on the bottom in contact with the episclera, and at the top is rounded in contact with the anterior surface. So this LX201 is available in two different lengths, that is 0.5 and another one is 0.75 inches. Each implant is 0.08 inches wide with a height of 0.04 inches. An episcleral plant developed by 3T Ophthalmics, that is Irwin's, that is in US, is also composed of silicon and looks like a tiny bathtub, less than 1 cm long. It can be refilled with drugs in any form such as solution, gel or matrix. Now Coming to the drug delivery system to the posterior segment of thigh, its intravitreal implants, and under this comes the DuraCert technology system. DuraCert technology system uses a drug core with one or more surrounding polymer layers and delivers the drugs for predetermined periods of time ranging from days to years. The drug release is controlled by permeability of the polymer layers. Using the DuraCert system, an antiviral drug, that is ganciclovir GCV loaded intravitreal implant, was used for the treatment of cytomegalovirus retinitis and has been developed as the first intravitreal drug delivery system which avoids systemic side effects and doesn't involve frequent intravitreal injections. This implant is made up of ethylene vinyl acetate and polyvinyl alcohol and releases ganciclovir by passive diffusion through a small opening in ethylene vinyl acetate base of the device for 6 to 8 months. Next one is the Retizert. Retizert is basically an intravitreal implant containing fluocinolone acetonide, which is approved by FDA for the treatment of non-infectious posterior uveitis. The constitution of the implant and the drug release duration are different from the above mentioned Vitrazert. The implant contains 0.5 mg of fluocinolone acetonide and was designed to deliver the drug for up to 1000 days. The Retizert implant is composed of central core consisting of fluocinolone acetonide compressed into a 1.5 mm diameter tablet. Each fluocinolone acetonide tablet is encased in a silicone elastomer cup containing a release orifice. A semi-permeable layer of polyvinyl alcohol coats the tablet inside the cup reservoir near the release orifice, creating a membrane between the tablet and the orifice that serves as an additional barrier for drug release from the cup. An injectable rod-shaped intravitreal implant with fluocinolone acetonide with a length of 3.5 mm and a diameter of 0.37 mm has been developed for the treatment of diabetic macular edema, that is Iluvien, and it is made up of polyimide and polyvinyl alcohol. It was small enough to be injected using an inserter with 25 gauze needle and is expected to provide sustained delivery of fluocinolone acetonide to the back of the eye for up to 3 years. It's NovaDure technology. Coming to the Ozurdex. Ozurdex is an intravitreal implant containing 0.7 mg of dexamethasone composed of PLGA with a length of 6.5 mm and diameter of 0.45 mm. It was approved by FDA in June 2009 for the treatment of macular edema due to the branch retinal vein occlusion, that is BRVO, and central retinal vein occlusion, that is CRVO. Ozurdex was administered by specially designed injector with a 22 gauze needle into vitreous cavity. Bryomanidine is a 2-adrenergic agonist which can release various nootropins including brain-derived neurotrophic factor and ciliary neurotrophic factor, CNTF. These neurotropins have a potential to prevent apoptosis of photoreceptors, PLGL intravitreal implant with two doses, that is 200 microgram and 400 microgram of brimonidine tartrate, similar to Ozurdex, is now in phase 2 clinical study for dry eye syndrome and phase 1 to 2 clinical trials for RP by Allergan Company. Another one is Ivation TA. Surmodix has a delivery system using Ivation technology for the delivery of triamcinolone acetonide into the vitreous humor. Ivation intravitreal implant is a titanium helical coil with a length of 0.5 mm, width of 0.21 mm, coated with triamcinolone acetonide and non-biodegradable polymers, that is polymethyl methacrylate and ethylene vinyl acetate. It is predicted that this implant will have an in vivo sustained delivery for a minimum of 2 years. At present, Ivation is in phase 1 clinical trials in patients with DME, and 24 months interim results were reported. At 24 months, 25 of 31 patients remained in the study. 11 patients, that means the 11 eyes in the slow release group, and 14 patients, that means the 14 eyes in the 14 release group, in the fast release group. The proportion of patients demonstrating improved visual acuity greater than 0 ETDRS letter gain from the baseline and was 64% in the slow release group and 72% in the fast release group. 28.6% of the patients in the fast release group gained greater than 15 letters. The mean macular thickness measured by OCT decreased in the slow group from 529 at the baseline to 328, and in the fast release group from 376 at the baseline to 268. Now the next one is injectable particulate system. Example is IBI 20089. Icon Bioscience of US is developing IBI 20089 containing triamcinolone acetonide using Verisome drug delivery platform technology. The Verisome is a translucent liquid. When the IBI 20089 mixes with saline, the solution becomes milky, slightly opaque color and forms a gel. Next one is the RETAC. Reports showing human studies of PLGA microspheres with triamcinolone acetonide, that is the RETAC system, have been studied. So this RETAC was injected intravitreally into the patients with diffuse DME, and their efficacy compared to the naked TA injections. So RETITAC treated eyes showed marked decrease of retinal thickness as well as improved visual acuity for 12 months. So this study demonstrated a superior long-term pharmacological performance when compared to the naked TA injected eyes. So RETAC was found to be safe and well tolerated by the retina. No drug or the procedure released related side effects were observed in this study. Another one is Cortiget. Cortiget is a Nova 63035 from Nova Galief Pharma. Is a preservative-free emulsion composed of oily carrier and phospholipid as surfactant encapsulated a target tissue activated corticosteroid prodrug. Released dexamethasone palmitate is deesterified by a retina specific esterase and activated to be dexamethasone. A single intravitreal injection provides sustained release over 6 to 9 months. Now the next one is Visudyne. Liposomes can also be designed to intervene in the intercellular biological responses between receptors and ligands in physiological or pathological conditions, and also to receive external signals by laser beam or an electric or magnetic field. Therefore, liposomes may become available for a drug targeting system. Visudyne was developed in the US is an intravenous liposomal formulation containing photosensitizer vertiporfin in photodynamic therapy for predominantly classic subfoveal choroidal neovascularization due to AMD, pathological myopia, or presumed ocular histoplasmosis. Plasma lipoprotein such as low-density lipoprotein LDL has been proposed to enhance the delivery of hydrophobic vertiporfin to malignant tissue, since the tumor cells have been shown to increase number of LDL receptors. In addition, it is reported that liposomes composed of negatively charged phospholipids such as phosphatidyl glycerol uptake into tumor cells by LDL receptor mediated endocytosis. It is thought that vertiporfin released in blood flow from liposome is associated with LDL and uptake in neovascular tissues, and undissociated vertiporfin still encapsulated in liposome is accumulated in the vascular endothelial cells via LDL receptor mediated endocytosis. Since phosphatidyl glycerol is a major constituent of Visudyne formulation. Now coming to the eye drops. Eye drops are the aqueous suspension of poorly water-soluble drugs and have some pharmaceutical problems including caking, poor redispersibility, which may affect the bioavailability due to the dosing error, and difficulty of filtration, sterilization due to the wide range of particle size. So difluprednate emulsion, it clears these problems and can more easily penetrate into the intraocular tissues compared to with its suspension. A non-randomized clinical study for refractive DME after vitrectomy with eye drops of difluprednate emulsion, that is Durazol, developed by Alcon Laboratories, was approved by FDA for the treatment of inflammation and pain. Associated ocular surgery was conducted to compare with subtenous injection of TA. The eye is one of the most complex organ in the human body, as mentioned in the previous review. Many successes in anterior drug delivery system are for prolonging the retention time and reducing the administration frequency have been achieved. Additional needs in this field might be to improve patients' and doctors' compliance. On the other hand, many implantable sustained drug delivery systems for chronic vitreoretinal diseases using biodegradable or non-biodegradable polymers are being developed. In order to reduce the side effects during long-term drug exposure, intelligent posterior drug delivery strategies which respond to external environment changes or disease-oriented pathophysiological signals are needed. Due to transparent ocular mediums, intraocular tissues like vitreous and retina are relatively easy to be observed without any invasion, and various administration approaches including intravitreal or subretinal injection implantation could be developed. In addition to Lucentis or monoclonal antibodies, since the eyeball is a closed organ, novel therapeutic molecules like antisense oligonucleotide for cytomegalovirus retinitis and aptamer, or a small interfering RNA for neovascular AMD have been investigated in human eye before their applications for systemic diseases. Therefore, more challenging approaches might be applicable in the ophthalmic field. Certainly, we should further consider the most efficacious combinations of optimal drugs, dose, route, and drug release pattern, like sustained release, pulsatile release, or controlled release responding to a trigger, according to the pathophysiology and progressive courses of the targeted disease. So students, let us summarize what we have learnt in this particular module. Many successes in the anterior drug delivery system and posterior drug delivery system for prolonging the retention time and reducing the administration frequency have been achieved. Now, additional efforts in this field are still required to be done to improve the patient and doctor compliance. Thank you.